Okay, so that was a record. Jules has been here since 2 o'clock this afternoon, and he took minus 2 seconds for us to have a technical issue because he didn't unmute the mic.
Yeah. He was busy in his defense.
He was busy doing what?
Working on everything else.
I can see this is going to be a long hour.
Yeah,
you should not have supported.
Okay.
Hello, everybody. With Sean and Brent from Rockets. The lovely, super lovely Carl Cassim.
Virtual one.
Super lovely Khanya Mkangisa. Hello, sweetheart.
Hi, guys.
Your personal favorite of Rockets and Carl Cassim.
Oh, did you guys hear that? Personal favorite at Rockets.
Literally personal favorite of Rockets. This is pretty good. Previous favorite of Rockets.
Previous favorite.
Previous favorite. New favorite.
Prior to lockdown, yeah.
I was 2017 favorite.
I don't even think I'm a new favorite.
Did you just call me old?
The time favorite.
Favorite. Carl was our favorite old. Like prior 2018.
Oh. Did you replace me?
2017.
Yeah.
That's what I do. So I replace
them. Hip hop. Is that what happened?
Pretty much. It's the way of the future.
Wow. Okay.
Bronze to beauty.
I've got some old John in the car.
Yes. Do you guys want to have your own show?
If I can, yeah. I won't turn it down.
I shouldn't offer that. Anyway, okay, we have a format.
Okay.
So, as you can see, or probably know, we start off with common sense is not so common. And we have three today.
Okay.
Okay, three common sense is not so common. Because we live in a not very common sense country right now. Number one, and I'm going to let our beautiful Jules chirp in with this one. Hey, Julesy. So, his son's coming back on Saturday.
Yep.
Okay. Now, common sense is not so common. Son coming from Italy?
Yeah.
Has to quarantine for
14 days.
Even if he tests negative for COVID-19.
Even if he tests negative. And it's compulsory 14 days, no matter what. In a 5-star hotel at 2,000 rand a night.
Oh, wow.
That the government is paying for.
Oh, okay.
Even if you register negative. Now, I would understand that if we were a COVID-19 free environment. Why do you need to self-quarantine if you're coming from somewhere that has less infections than us? It's not like you're bringing something we don't have.
Especially if you test negative.
If you test negative, why?
Infections where they are.
Why are you testing? I don't know. I don't get it. At what expense? I don't get it.
It's a 5-star hotel for 14 days.
Which is pretty cool.
It's
and you quarantine with your chick.
Can I take a date? What's the story?
Yeah. Can you order in?
Yeah.
Is it Netflix? What are the options?
Everything.
PlayStation?
Everything.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's the thing. I've been asked to drop off the PlayStation.
Really? Interesting.
But how do you get it to him when he's quarantining?
I have to drop
leave
it
at
bag,
the door.
Sealed bag outside at the hotel, which they will then take from me and take to.
But what happens if you've got, say, you've got COVID, but now you've sealed the bag.
They disinfect the bag.
Oh, they do?
Well, we
hope so.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Okay, so that's one. Number two is, our firm favorite, still can't go and see your mom.
Any family members.
You can't, but you can get in a taxi that's full with 14 people. Mask not obligatory if it's going a long distance. To your mom's house, but you can't walk inside and see your mom. But you can sit in the casino, sit in a restaurant, sit in anything that you want. Coffee shop, can't go and see a family member. I don't get it.
You can sit in a restaurant without a mask because you're eating and drinking.
No, not drinking. Oh.
You can't drink.
Coffee.
Coffee.
Orange
juice.
Wash your mouth.
Speaking of that,
yeah. Okay, and number three, we have to bring this up because it's just affected us massively again. Is the 9 o'clock curfew? 9 o'clock curfew, and you can't drink alcohol at a restaurant. And you know why they did the 9 o'clock curfew?
Why?
Because there was a prolific increase in unregulated parties and house parties. And why was there a prolific increase? Because you weren't allowed to drink alcohol in restaurants.
Yeah.
Hmm. So the whole exactly the whole
crazy.
The whole let's not drink alcohol in restaurants gave rise to unregulated underground parties, which gave rise to a spike in COVID-19 infections, which has now increased the lockdown. So they wouldn't have had to do this if they just allowed restaurants to operate as they could.
Yeah.
You know, us, and I just, we did an interview now for ENCA, and the one thing he said, okay, well, what got you through lockdown? What got us through lockdown was knowing that, okay, we're 2 to 4 weeks behind overseas. Restaurants overseas are able to trade and within certain parameters, but get up to 70% of their revenue because they're using tables that are 1.5 meters apart. We thought we were going to do that. We're the only country on earth that said no alcohol in restaurants. Remember, 65% of your revenue is from alcohol, from beverages.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
The 35% that's food, that's not spent by people not drinking alcohol.
No.
Yeah.
All right. It's 35% spent on food that is done by people drinking alcohol during their dinner.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't make sense. Mm. Maybe 1 or 2% of our entire revenue curve comes from people who don't drink at all.
Yeah.
You know?
One only, geez.
Me and you.
Yeah.
Wow. Speak for yourself.
Well, no. But anyway.
Wow.
Hey?
Yeah.
Mm.
Okay. Well, listen. We have a pre-recorded meal today that Mark prepared. We did Dalmides. Hey?
Yep.
Did I say that right?
What? What is that?
Dalmades.
Dalmades.
I've never heard of that, and I thought I was a foodie.
So like you should need a hand movement with it.
It's not Italian. It is a Greek.
Greek.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure they wave their hands.
Do Greeks wave their hands?
My friends do.
A lot.
Do they?
Yeah.
See, I've loved
Dalmades.
It. Yeah. Like, yeah, it's more of a...
The Italians go makakak, so...
What is
Dalmades? I will show you. So Mark's had done a pre-record one. He's going to come sit with us and take us through it. We thought that actually works better.
Yeah.
Lovely. But let's... I want to dive down into our guests.
Ooh.
Ooh, who's first?
Ladies first.
Mm. Ladies first.
Carl.
Well,
so
tell us about
Carl.
Put in that one, eh? Yeah, okay.
And I've been a guest before, so he has to go first.
Yes.
Been
I think so.
She has been
a guest.
It really is the new fave.
He told you, though, I am the new fave.
I like this very much.
No, so tell us, my brother, how's lockdown been? Terrible. Because people don't realize it's the entertainment industry is locked down.
Bro,
DJs
completely locked down.
There's only so much streaming of a DJ spinning some decks up that you can.
I mean, I thought you were going to pay me to beer, but that's not happening.
You pay your
pay in kind. As I said earlier, brother, the last time I performed was 4 months ago exactly. So it's the 15th, eh?
Yes.
So I haven't performed for 4 months exactly. 15th of March is my last gig. So, I mean, if say to anyone, we're taking away 4 months of your salary.
Mm.
Cheers, man. I'm fortunate enough to have radio, so at least I still have an income from 5FM every month, which is holding me together, bro. Anyone, you can't just take someone's income away. It's not cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And that goes to say with everyone, not just DJs, not just producers. There's people in every part of the entertainment industry, your waitresses, stage managers. So it's been tough. I've taken up running as a hobby.
Really?
Wow.
I've started a
runner. Are you slimmer?
I don't know. I'll take the jacket off just now. We can see.
Okay. Because you started boxing at one stage.
Yeah. I bought a boxing bag from my house as well now.
Okay. Can you crack it, Butch?
Brother, from the East End.
Benoni.
Benoni boy. So
that's what people don't realize about lockdown, is that it's DJs.
Yeah.
But think about it, and this upsets me so much, because it's restauranteering is a controlled environment. We transformed our bars and our clubs into restaurants, seated tables. You could be playing right now. There could be an industry to play to.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're just playing to people who are sitting down enjoying dinner. Granted, we won't be able to pay the full fee that you normally charge, but we'll pay 60, 70% of it.
Yeah.
You know?
At least there's still a gig.
You know, it's something. It is something. You get 50% of the people are subscribed to the dangers of COVID, and so do we. And I think, you know, everyone, every man for himself, stay home. The 50% that want to go out and socialize, let them do so.
Mm.
Let them do so, because they want to go out and have a couple of drinks.
Yeah.
And then, bang, industry on. Just like that.
And I think a lot of people were planning for that, but now it's just been pulled. The plug's been pulled. A couple of venues were saying, hey, Carl, we want to rent your equipment. We want to put it here. We want to have like 50 people just stationed around the venue, play some deep house, chill out.
Mm.
People are missing that. And I mean, you need that.
You can have a controlled environment with responsible people.
The rest of the world's doing it.
The rest of the world's doing it.
All my DJ friends around the world, and it's like, oh, what's going on down there?
The rest of the world is doing it, and I don't understand what makes our country think that we should do something that no one else is doing. No one else is doing it.
Mm.
You have a controlled environment where people can enjoy themselves within parameters that make them responsible.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, don't put measures in place that force people to do things on their own accord. Show me a house party where someone's at the door with a temperature gauge, or saying you can't come in without a mask, or sanitizing your table and your surface, or stopping you from being a meeting. What house party has ever done that?
Shooting smokes.
Mm. Yeah, I don't want even starting the smoker and smoking ban, but it's just, you know, I feel for us as restaurateurs, but I'm acutely aware of the pain that's been for DJs. DJs are our families, you know?
Yeah.
It's heavy. First family, second family.
First, you know, I'm when a you DJ have two children too, you in know, the family, Cal, okay. There's a firstborn, and then like...
The lastborn's normally the favorite, so
yeah, but
actually...
Like, we have got to look after the little one. The firstborn grows up, he's like, hey, he's on his own mission.
We kicked the firstborn out the nest.
Yeah, I see, because I was flying.
Family favorite.
We kind of abandoned us.
we'll make amends.
Khan, what have you been doing?
Acting, luckily. Imagine if I was just a DJ. Thank God
no
for
offense.
Acting. Well, he's on radio, so he's cool.
Really? You really are the favorite.
Yeah, man, if it wasn't for the acting, I really don't know what I'd be doing, honestly. Last gig as well on the 15th. Yeah, at Rockets. Told you I was the favorite.
But, I mean, we were doing a YFM talent search for young entrepreneurs. And Ayanda was on, and she heads up MTV. And she said their reality TV shows have all been cut. They're doing 1 out of 4 at the moment because you can't do a reality TV show or venue. You know what I mean? It's fine on set where everyone is compliant. But reality TV shows, you follow the people around.
Yeah. Mm.
Cut. Boom. Mm. So just as well, you're not a reality TV actor.
No.
Well, to give you some insight into my life with that, just before COVID, we had written my pilots for my reality show. Everything was set. We had everything was there. We were ready to shoot. Boom.
Yeah.
Sponsors pulled out. No one, we can't afford crews, it's gone. Now, what do we do? We've got this project waiting there.
You start again.
Yeah, start from scratch.
Listen, same with us.
We've gone to TikTok, I don't know.
Yeah, I saw that, actually.
Yeah.
I saw that.
TikTok.
Well, we're building rockets in Menin, you know? We got halfway, boom. And then COVID came, brand pulled out, all brand sponsorship pulled out because their budgets are cut.
Yeah.
F&B pulled their loan. So now we're trying to finish a 30 million rand restaurant. How?
No, you can't. It's not possible.
It's a lot of burgers we're going to have to sell on the street side, eh?
Yeah.
So
good. I've got a solution.
No one cares, Jules.
I do. No, I do. I want to hear it.
We do care, Julesy. What is your solution?
Live stream funerals.
Oh, wow. Okay.
You went there so soon.
Let's bring him out. You know what? As we... As we get further and further, I think we're on to episode 20 of Rockets TV. Now, Jules thinks it's his, but let's talk about Jules quickly. So, the world's best live streamer, by the way, and he's a family member of ours, so we get it like pretty much family rates for zero. But he is now live streaming funerals.
Are you ready?
Oh, so he wasn't joking.
No, he wasn't joking.
Because families can't be there in mass.
What a great business.
I've actually seen two of those.
Live streaming funerals. But you can have 20 people at the funeral, and there's maybe 200. That one who live stream in. It's the next best thing from being there.
Oh, but that's creepy though.
I know, but
I don't think it's creepy, I think it's great, man.
Innovation.
How is it creepy?
It's a business, people die.
Yeah, then leave it at that. Like, keep it there. Like, don't bring it in my home.
You just can't say stupid things like, oh, our feed is dead.
Oh wow.
We've lost the feed.
Oh wow.
Okay.
But what a great business. I'm telling you, Jules, that's fantastic. Because if you think about it, even out of COVID, you've got people overseas who want to be part of the event.
And they can't get you.
Yeah. And you've got a never ending supply of people dying.
Oh wow.
So you're winning right now, Jules.
I'm not talking COVID. I'm not being insensitive to COVID. Is that insensitive?
No, because the COVID death rate is minimal. So.
Sorry, there's actually less people dying now than there were. So
yeah,
you're going to be busier out of COVID, bro. Huh? But even like, that's a great business. I'm super jealous about that.
Rockets.
I would love to be in that. If you need a partner there, brother, please. You know?
You need background music.
Carl DJ.
Carl DJ.
Voiceovers.
Khanya can present.
No, I'm good.
You're going to present, so we're here.
Oh, no, I'm good, guys. Leave me out of this
one. You're going straight in, eh?
Yeah, why not?
Reel it in, boy. Reel it in. Bring it back home.
And you charge more for open casket where you got to do face shots.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
And if you run out of bodies, just let us know.
And you like, as you're filming, you just put a hand through and you stroke the face in the casket.
Okay.
No, okay, guys, no enough.
I think it's a great business.
My son.
Okay, man.
I like
so
it.
I just keep quiet. Yeah.
Who is he?
Right?
It's a great business. Anyway, Kali, background, please, quickly. Background. Where did you grow up? Why did you become a DJ? What were you doing beforehand?
I've always wanted to be a DJ. I've always wanted to be a radio DJ as well. I mean,
you are.
My first initial radio story was when I was 13 years old. I met Mark Pilgrim and Sachin Martinengo at a beer fest. 13 years ago is a long time. I know.
And you were 13 years old?
I was 13. I met
at
them
a beer fest?
It was, but they had under 18 areas back then.
Oh,
it was
okay.
Cool.
Okay.
Not that you were staying in your area.
Were they
pedophiles in the under 18 area?
No, but I was cool. Anyway, my dad had organized with Sachin Martinengo and Mark Pilgrim to get me into the DJ box that day because it was my birthday. My 13th birthday. He got me into the DJ box and I said to them, little Kyle, I said, I want to be on 5 FM one day as well. And they signed my shirts saying, hey Kyle, keep up the passion. I still have that shirt 500 years later.
Cute.
So from That's a primary cool. school child, I always wanted to go into DJ, into radio. And it was a long journey. I mean, there were times I studied law for 4 years. You don't know that.
I think I do. Where did you go to school?
Vernoni, St. Dunstan's.
He's proper beast from the east. We do it.
No, that's a different east.
St. Dunstan's is like the north of the east.
Yeah,
it's like the Sandton of the east.
Bro, there's nothing hard about St. Dunstan's.
Don't say Benoni, bro.
Don't say the east.
I went to Tux and it took a long time. I mean, there was days when I had no money because you're on that hustle. You're just trying to play any gig. You're playing for free. You're doing online stuff. And it's been a long but very cool journey. But as I say, it's only still beginning. Right now, that it's stopped because of COVID.
Pause.
I'm now a professional runner if anyone wants to.
And a boxer.
And a boxer. I'm boxing, running, and making TikToks.
And a jiggalo.
Boxing, running, and
TikToks. We're going to get there. We're going there.
And a pending reality star.
Yeah, hopefully next year this time I'm inviting you guys to my TV show.
Yeah, bro.
It's all thumbs
we'll be
it
there.
It'll happen.
Yeah.
It'll
if
happen.
You want us, we're there.
I don't know. The way you just spoke about funerals, I don't want you on my show ever.
Taste death, live life.
So yeah, that's my background, man. I still have a lot of aspirations in terms of...
So did you do 4 years of law school?
Yeah.
4 years?
4 years,
which
man.
Is pretty much your full undergrad.
Yeah. I actually...
Did you finish the 4 years?
I used to tell people
did you fail,
I dropped
did you fail first
I
year
used
four
to tell,
times?
I used to actually tell people I dropped out, and then this
exactly
weekend I told
them.
You did first year four times.
Four
you
times.
Did 4 years in law school.
I actually am quite an intelligent person.
Okay,
wow.
Okay.
I believe.
And I actually used to tell people I dropped out.
As hard as that is to believe. You got kicked out of Tux?
I actually got kicked out of Tux.
For what?
For never writing exams.
You slept with your lecturer.
What
was his name?
No, I wish that would be a great story.
He said his name, you know.
That's a great story.
Yeah. But why weren't you writing exams?
Because I was naughty. So I was trying to DJ and I was concentrating on DJing and I was waking up and going I was doing all my work throughout the year, but I was never actually rocking up the exams. I don't know. In the back of my mind, I did not want to finish this degree. So throughout the year, I would do my work, hand in assignments, but when it came down to the crux of it, I'd go out to 5 o'clock in the morning and just not go to my exam.
The night before an exam?
Yeah.
Well, that's what happens when you're a DJ.
Yeah.
I'd have a 6 a.m. call time and I'm in the club till 5 o'clock.
I've been
I'd still make it and I'd still go there and do all my scenes and know my work.
But you know what? There's a world famous comedian, Eddie Izzard. Mm-hmm. Eddie Izzard. Said the same thing because he was a professional about to get his qualification,
mm-hmm.
and he purposefully dropped out to do comedy. And they said to him, "Why did you drop out?" He said, "Because I never wanted that fallback. I wanted to be so hungry in being a successful comedian that I didn't. That safety net wouldn't have made me sharp enough."
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
You know.
I think that's a nail on the head because I knew that I needed to not have anything else to like, okay, I'm going to go into corporate. I can be a lawyer one day if it doesn't work out. I was like, I need to make this DJ thing work. My mom came to me one day and it made me so angry. And she said, Kyle, I love you, but there is only one DJ Fresh. There's only one Roger Good. There's only one Roger Good. There's only one Gareth Cliff. And I turned around to her and I was young. I was probably about 21 to 24. I can't remember. It's a long time ago. And I turned around and I said, well, there's only going to be one Kyle Cassim.
Good for you.
And I literally did not stop working until 5 FM headhunted me. I never went to them. They came to me.
Ooh.
I still remember the phone call. I shat myself. Can I say shat myself?
Yeah. Of course you can. You can say shit yourself.
I was still lying in my ex-girlfriend's bed and my phone rang and the station manager's name was Justine Cullinan. She said shat, I might as well say ex-girlfriend. If Sean phones, they're like, hey Sean, hey Brent, Justine Cullen. Hey Carl, it's Justine Cullen from Farm. Hello.
Yeah.
My
that's
voice is like,
been waiting for.
Yeah.
She said, I hope that's not your rest. Your
and I was like, that's
voice.
Not my radio voice, I promise. And yeah, that was 4 years ago, man. October's 4 years that I've been in 5 FM.
Nice.
So, yeah, it's been cool. It's nice.
And it's Tuesdays, Fridays, Saturdays?
It used to be Tuesdays, Fridays, Saturdays. My Friday is now long. It's a 4-hour show on a Friday instead of having the 1 hour on a Tuesday.
Okay.
Four hours on a Friday and 3 hours on a Saturday.
Awesome.
Nice.
Yeah. Bro, you play the best music on that show.
Yeah, that's
bro. And I'm not saying that because you're a good mate of mine.
He creepy voice notes. Like fangirl voice notes. He does.
You know what? I'll be driving between the restaurants on a Friday night listening to him and then I'll just fuck with him a bit.
Come. But it's more of like a flirtation thing. Like, none of the show, come past Rockets.
He's a good looking guy. I can't help myself.
So it's more of a flirtation thing.
What did your mom say about it when you got that call?
She was ecstatic, man.
She happy?
Yeah. I mean,
because that's pretty much it. I mean,
yeah.
In terms of dance music, 5FM is where it's at. And
yeah, I mean, my show, in terms of what I do, and I don't want to pat myself on the back or say anything, but in terms of what I do, there is no one else in South Africa that does that.
Nice.
Yeah.
That touches on European dance, Dutch dance, UK dance, Australian dance, South African dance music, like everything. There's no one else that is bringing that whole BBC radio vibe to South Africa. Which is cool. It's built up an nice following, and I love my demographic. My demographic is black, white, Indian, coloured. It's everyone.
Yeah.
It's not that I'm only playing to one race or sex. It's everyone. It makes me really happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's power, bro. So.
What time is your show?
Friday is
6 to 10.
He's at work. He's.
I didn't even know you were on radio until now.
He's here at Rockets. How's he supposed to know?
I'm sorry. Are you?
Oh,
okay, wait. Yeah, look at that. Did you
exactly.
See? Are you getting jealous?
Okay.
Okay, we're going to hop on to Khans. But don't you want to play some music?
Okay, let's.
Yes. Let's
show. Any requests?
Whatever floats your boat.
Shanti Jarl. Where would I be without my baby?
Are you ready, Jules? Get ready for technical issues. Are we going to be able to hear her?
Yeah.
Wait, guys, I still have to find the song or not? Am I like.
Just play your
jam,
bro.
You've
got
to come to see.
Let's see what's
going on. Yo, can you go half off?
Yeah.
Go half off? Ah, you can't go half off, you suck.
Okay. Things.
But
like, don't like stare at me. That's like
stalker.
Vibe.
Is that weird?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, don't
stare. Can they still hear us? No.
Are we muted?
No, you're not.
No, we are live.
Not now. You're waiting for the music to come.
For me?
Yes.
I'm playing.
Told you. Technical issues. You might have to come back to us.
I'm not getting.
Okay, come back to us. So, we have got.
I hope it's not me. But I
told you. I told you. I told you.
Well,
I want to talk about Mark quickly. Marky, do you want to come and screen while we get a gap? Come.
Yeah.
I can sing while I'm playing.
Yeah.
I'm doing. I could.
Okay, so by now everybody knows Mark's our exec chef. Have you met Carl?
Hi, Mark.
How's this, my good
day? Okay, I'll be shake.
Yeah.
There we go.
You just keep your distance.
Yeah.
Please. Okay, so. You made for us today, Mark Cypriot, by the way.
Cypriot.
Half Cypriot, half German.
Okay. Half Cypriot, half German. Oh, there's a German side. Gave
Dalmatis.
You yours.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you've made Dalmatis.
Dormades.
There's an old man.
Dormades.
Or Gubepia.
What?
Gubepia.
Okay, cool.
But we'll stay with Dormades.
Why have we never put that on a menu? Because I just tasted it and it's fantastic.
Well, I was actually thinking about it, like, it's a tapas and it's absolutely amazing. And that's actually why I wanted to make it,
it's
so that
so
you can
good.
Give it a taste and see how good it is. And you can either have it hot or cold, it makes no difference. It's
what
just
is this?
So it's basically, it's vine leaves.
I'm not going to show it on the...
Vine leaves.
There's
I'm
actually
sure
a video,
they have
so...
First.
Is it the wrapped?
How are we doing with the song?
Yeah, I have that though.
Jules?
Yeah.
No song yet? I told you, bro. What did I say? I said test it first.
Yes, you did test it.
Oh, sure. Looks like it.
Do you want the video?
Yeah, I think let's... Can you play the video and Mark's going to walk us through it?
Cool.
Yeah. Yeah, David, leave it there. We'll bring it on now. Okay, so take us through what you're doing, bro.
Okay, so it's basically chopping up. There we go.
Yeah.
So it's chopping up the tomatoes. You de-seed it.
What does de-seeding tomatoes mean?
So you're just basically cutting out the center part with the seeds.
Okay.
And then I'm basically going to just slice it up into little diced. So one of the things when you're cutting is you basically slice it, and what a lot of people do wrong, if you watch, I move the food to suit where I'm standing. A lot of people adjust their hands.
Yes, when you cut yourself.
Yeah, so they're trying to cut it at an awkward angle. So it just goes a lot easier if you move the food to where your knife is.
Okay.
So we've got the tomato. There's an onion. So the onion, and another major thing people do wrong with an onion is they always cut the end off.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've seen.
I've always cut the end off every single onion.
Never ever do it, because if you watch now, when I'm slicing it like that, that end bit holds the entire onion together. So it holds it, and then the onion, if you don't do it, it can basically slip around. And this way, the end bit just holds the whole onion together.
Slide away as you're
That's
holding.
It. So as you're holding it, even if you do make a mistake, it's holding in, and you're not
going
to slip.
You know that,
Carl?
Next time you cook your next.
I've just learned something.
Your next chick at your house
cool.
that you cook dinner for.
Yeah, she's got a cooking show.
Ready?
You had a cooking show? Or you
I still have a cooking show.
But you can't cook.
Have you had some food?
No, I've never been invited.
Alright,
we'll do one here.
Okay.
Yeah. That's basically, that cutting method is chiffonade, so it's basically cutting your parsley as thin as possible. Just, I see a lot of guys when they're cutting, you know, they're doing this whole with rocking the knife backwards and forwards, and it's pretty much a waste of time. You can, if you bunch all the parsley together and just slice once, it's done. So then I've got pork mince. I take the pork mince, put the parsley in.
You guys didn't check if I eat the lal though, I made pork.
No comments. Apple. Absolutely no comment there, Briggs.
We have chilies outside. We have chilies outside. We okay. He's okay.
I mean, focus on the food.
Okay.
Stop making this about you.
So just to not waste anything, I took the tomato seeds. And just for flavor, I quickly chopped them up. And I'm going to put them in the bottom of the pot. Because, you know, a lot of people will either throw it away. And that's just more flavor that's basically going to go into your food. And it just creates a really nice base as I'm rolling the dormades to put them on top of it.
Okay.
Okay, then where are we sitting now? So there we're gonna put in the onion, tomato, parsley, and pork mince. And then it's literally
pork
salt.
Mince.
Yeah, pork mince.
So
you can use
mighty.
Beef, like a lot of people do use beef. Just the traditional.
What's
you
the classic one? Pork.
Pork. Yeah.
Okay. Can you eat pork there, darling?
I love pork.
Okay, good.
Awesome. Okay, then we're adding in rice. Just some straight from the packet, which is basically
not
pre-cooked. It's because the vine leaves actually take quite a while because they are quite stringy, even though they are brine. And then you cook them for like 2-3 hours basically, and that just softens it a little bit and as it cooks the rice. And then you leave it. If you listen to my father will tell you that it has to rest for an hour before you're allowed to eat it.
Okay.
The food must relax, apparently. So then I'm just putting a little bit of cinnamon as well. And then you just basically mix it all in together.
Just like that?
Yeah, just like that.
That is so easy.
Yeah, it's like...
What?
Like, I'll tell you the story. So my dad used to make this for me growing up, my entire life.
Yeah.
I only learned to make this 3 months ago.
You're joking.
Because it was always my dad made it. So there was no need for me to make it. And now with them obviously getting a little bit older, I thought I need to learn all of these dishes that my parents have taken for granted, that they're always just there.
Yeah. So, the vine?
Okay, so that's basically the vine leaves. You buy them in a jar at
what
spa. Vine? No, vine.
Like
so
vine, vine?
Yeah, like from a grape.
Is that the dumbest thing I ever had?
No. I didn't know. I'm glad you asked.
No.
Okay, cool.
So
I'm not
we
glad
all
at all.
Thinking it.
we were here. Pick me.
So it's like legit from the grape tree. And they're basically just brine.
Like heard it on the grapevine.
Yeah. Grapevine. So
you see? Fucking roll on, man.
So you just take them and you're basically rolling them like a little cigar and you're putting them in the pot, as you can see I'm doing there. Dave came to help as well. And you're just layering them in the pot, and as you get more you put them on top of each other. And then it's a little bit of chicken stock which you put on top of it. And then the most important part is the next part, you actually put a plate over it. Because with the water, if you don't have the plate, they will float up and unwrap.
Yeah.
So
okay.
With the plate on, it basically holds it down, and as they cook, the protein in the meat as well helps keep the entire shape of the yeah. So and then obviously once they've cooked for 2-3 hours and you leave them to rest for an hour more or less, and then that's it, they're
incredible.
Done.
What do you serve it with?
So I serve it with traditionally it goes with the Greek yogurt. That's pretty much it.
What do we have over there?
No, we
smoked.
So we've got the Greek yogurt.
Okay, I'll bring it, Dave.
Dave's dying to bring it.
Dave, you know why it tastes good? It's because Dave helped you do it.
Not
okay.
A chance, so.
There we go.
That's for
Dave Carl. Rolled.
Said
yeah,
Red Dolmades.
That's for Carl.
Dolmades.
Yeah,
Dolmades.
Yeah. Let me get a proper look here. Want to go?
No, I'd love one. Thank you.
Grab one. Just dunk it in there.
Are you jealous?
No, I'm not.
You jealous?
Come try it.
You want one?
Come try.
Yeah.
Was we come feed you?
Should we place some music?
I mean, you seem like you want
not
to.
Not yet.
Offers are.
Thank you.
I'm going to feed it, guys. I'll be back.
Okay, I'll go to that screen.
Yeah, come this way.
Here we go. And love is born.
Yeah.
There we go. And how's that? Good? Let me know if you want some more.
Okay.
I'm just over there.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
What's it called?
Dull Mothers.
Say that. You want to play music for us?
Sister.
You never thought I'd make you smile while I'm smacking your ass and fucking you all wild. But we share something so rare, but who cares? You can, baby.
I'm not always there when you call, but I'm always on time. And I gave you my all. Now, baby, be mine. I'm not always there when you call, but I'm always on time. And I gave you my all. Now, baby, be mine.
Get a grip, come on. Together, it's only a sun shower. We've been through worse weather, like the stormy night. You wrote a dead child letter. It took my Benz and keyed and cut the leather. Bitch, you know better. The MOB, money over bitches, murder INC. I got 2 or 3 hoes for every V, and I keep them drugged up off that ecstasy. I'm a playground legend like Kirk and Pee Wee. They my nigga in the league, got more game than me. I play harder, so many women I bothered. Meet them with scars and sit them home, hot and bothered. Truth. Yeah, this life ain't a parent.
in a love with no glare is a crystal stare. But we share something so rare. But who cares? You can, baby.
I'm not always there when you call, but I'm always on time. And I gave you my all. Now, baby, be mine. I'm not always there when you call, but I'm always on time. Yeah. And I gave you my all. Yeah. Now, baby, be mine.
Oh, I'm feeling like you're living a double life.
Cause we stadium status, yeah. And we the baddest team, woo, we the baddest team, ah, yeah. And we the baddest team, woo, we the baddest team, woo. Tell me where you beat there, tell me where you beat there. Club going up, kings of the weekend. Solid gold chain over silk V-neck. First you get the money, then you get the respect. I be with the knock guy, living easy. Let's put the blunt on, it's my teammate. Bought a sports car, it's a real East Day. Now them niggas can't stand when they see me.
I'm Shabata, that's my babe. Bus kata si kafa ma K. Yes, my band si bamba ma bay. And y'all still can't keep up with my pace. So Sim Tebele can't keep us down. And I wish you were there, must keep a gun. My click, get ahead, must figure out love. One chick in the bed, five skippers laugh. I got more, but you wouldn't want the truth. You headed to the top floor, I'm chilling on the roof. Handy to the goose, from the kitchen to the booth. Heavy with the youth, war ready with the proof. I don't want it all, I just want a bad fella. They never took calls, no, they lost my fella. Took her to the mall, Gandos and Papella. Man, never mang, and I reply with Mandela's my mella.
You like baddest, yeah. Mother on the planet, baby. Take a picture with the cameras, yeah. Double stadium status, ooh, yes. Yeah, we are the baddest team, oh. We are the baddest team, oh. Yeah, yeah. We are the baddest team, oh. The baddest team, oh. I know one, baby. We are the baddest team, oh, the baddest team, whoa, 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 boy. We are the baddest team, oh, we are the baddest team.
My outfit on some, this ain't out yet. Money talk, this is a public service announcement. Everyone know who the baddest in the South is. So I put my gold status where my mouth is. Do you know what it feel like to get to the pinnacle? Beverly Hills life, let's dip in the swimming pool. We getting physical, let's fuck in the living room. I'm in my element, and you got the minerals, it's critical. Every rap king need a theme song. Every trap queen need a King Kong. Put you on the team, put the ring on. Long live, super mega live long. My best are you to miss a piece of my jigsaw. Champagne bottle stained with your lip gloss. Weekend getaway to the big balls. I'm a big star, run the game, Chris Paul.
Just a second, mommy, wanna speak out. What I need in my life, make the body freak out. Baby seem like the type, marry niggas sneak out. Like I'm ballin', y'all. Guess I'll be appalling, y'all.
hype, hold it down. Wanting all of y'all, calling y'all, never chasing me down. 3 weeks, heartbroken, yes, you hating me now. She speaks, soft spoken till she dating the clown. I'm taking them down, reel them in and making them drown. Mistake, I say give me bet, I'm taking it now. What I need from a nigga, negative in the sound. Audacity, even asking me for ass. I laugh, this bitch is fast and free. Swatting them off when I see this nigga's a flea. Plotting the call for riches, millionaire wannabe.
What y'all niggas want?
What we want, my?
Can't touch. All y'all niggas need.
What we need in our lives.
Right here with me. Sounds y'all wanna hear.
Who that? Who that?
Swiss beats. I'm the one to fear. It's my time.
Popular love since I started my life. If you know my name, probably the dangerous side. Brick house, stallion, think you taming me right? Not this baby down, Philly streets, they raising a riot. Keep it pretty, okay, make it gritty, be a lady. Need boots, pocket books, and a baby 380. But prefer to keep it calm and cool. When I'm heated, I suggest you move. Just avoid a bad situation, but you got the
proof. Oh, are you playing this for me? This is also one of my favorite songs.
I knew it.
I love this song.
I
have a song in my car.
All for you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Must I put on pause or do you have
a
thing?
We got it.
We got it.
Here's my Red Bull. There it is. And I'd love to have it on camera.
What, a Red Bull?
Yeah. I mean, they're not paying us, but maybe it'll be a hint that they should.
Yeah. Don't show the branding.
Okay, yeah. That's okay. What I was asking. Okay, cool.
So we're going to talk about you now.
Mmm, so quickly. Let me have a quick sip.
Courage.
Mmm.
So where are we from? Don't say East London.
Oh, don't ask. Skip.
No, tell us.
I mean,
no, yeah, you have.
Eastern Cape. Eastern Cape.
You're from Eastern Cape.
Why'd you say East London? I thought you meant.
Oh, you are.
Well, my mom is, but I'm a Joburg girl.
Where did you grow up? Joburg?
Yeah.
Where were you born? East London.
I was born in Pedi, which is literally one robot. If you like blink, it's between Grahamstown and King, then you'll miss it.
We say we have a standing joke because so much of the talent we get on the show is from East London.
I know, right?
It's that
Eastern Cape baby.
No, not East Randon.
No. It's the coast. There's something in the water in the Eastern Cape. I don't know what it is, but
there is a huge amount of talent that comes from that area of the world. Well, that we've met. It's mad.
I know. I don't know what it is.
So then, okay, born in Pedi, moved to Joburg when?
When I was a baby. It was just me and my mom never got married. I'm an only child, so
Joburg
it was just
where?
Like observatory when we moved.
Because
she was working in the area, and then I went to observatory girls for 1 year, and then I went to Waverley Girls for high school.
Waverley Girls like pick and pay, huh?
Waverley Girls.
Yeah. I mean, if I had a choice, I would have gone next door to St. Mary's, but hey.
Dee also a Waverley girl.
Yes.
No, Dee over there in the corner.
Oh. Really?
Waverley's definitely pick and pay then.
Yeah.
Pick and lay.
When you were there, who was the mistress? Oh, really? You can't even remember. Okay.
1989.
Oh. Were you born by 1989?
Just. No.
I mean, honestly, the questions you guys are asking today are just like, why are you asking me that?
Okay, I want to get into a talented. Okay, so after school, then what?
So while I was in high school at Waverley, I won a presenter search, which was national, for YoTV. So I won the whole thing. There were like over 3,000 kids that entered. And I won, and I became a YoTV presenter while I was in high school. So I had to like quit the netball team, everything, because I had
that
a job.
That must have been catastrophic, quitting the netball
team. I know, it really was. Guys, that was good.
I was on the first team.
I know, but I'm center, and I'm like, if you're good, you're good.
It's for them to stand on your back to jump up.
Guys, I was really good.
I bet you were faster.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
I was saying that I was captain of the first team.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
I mean, I don't understand why you guys don't believe that.
Why did you play hockey?
Why didn't I?
Yeah.
Because I can play both. But like netball, I'm more of a netball girl. I mean, like, you can't be both.
Are you on MVP's netball team? You would kill it there.
I would. I should actually. But
I bet they've asked.
I mean, is this interview about like MVP or me?
Oh no, let's get over the interview. Okay, so then talent, presenter search, boom, because it's amazing.
Yes, and then I win the whole thing, and I'm still in grade 10.
So you're 16, 15?
Yeah, I was 15, so after school I'd have to go to work, go to Urban Brew, shoot, so I was that girl. And then the teachers started, like all the teachers used to like me, then they were like, okay, well you had to quit this, they didn't like me much. people, all the girls at my school started acting different, but I was like, it's still
That's
me, I'm just on TV
That's
now.
Heavy, yeah.
Yeah, but it helped, like, helped me develop a thick skin, so now I'm, like, very chilled with, like, not chilled, but, like, when things happen in the industry, or, like, if I have, like, bad press for whatever reason, I'm just like, oh.
I mean, we'll get there.
No!
We'll get to the bad press.
Yeah, so, no, it was really cool. It taught me my independence, you know, working from a young age. It was really cool.
And then came acting, presenting acting.
Yes.
Did
so
you go to acting school?
No, so actually while I was presenting, I'd obviously always interview a lot of actors, a lot of celebrities. Then I was like, okay, there's something I'd want to go into. And so I matriculated and then I went to AFDA. But then I figured, let me not major in acting because I'd actually already started acting. So I majored in editing, funny enough.
Oh, wow.
Hey, Jules.
Not just a pretty face.
Mm-hmm. But I didn't really enjoy
just
it.
Just like you be.
But yeah, it was one of those. So then, yeah, that's me. And the DJing obviously came years later. I always wanted to do it. I'd always, like, tell...
Your DJing, you can thank us.
Listen,
I owe my
entire DJing career to you guys. You guys know it.
Yeah, us and Jordan.
Yes, definitely.
Us.
I mean, all of you guys.
No,
three of
just
you.
Brent and I. Not Jordan, we just allowed him to think it was him. We taught you how to DJ.
You really did.
And then gave her first gig.
Why don't you bring me here to help?
Because
maybe you would have started playing house music then.
No, I never wanted to play house. Oh. So my debut gig was obviously at Rockets. It was on my birthday.
That's so cool.
And I was just like trying it out because I was like, what if people are like, oh, what is
you
she
doing? You were nervous,
eh? Yes, I was so nervous. That's why I was like, okay, let me do it on my birthday so that if it doesn't work out, I can just be like, no, it was a birthday thing. It wasn't like a real thing. And then after I played, then everyone was calling me like, oh my gosh, you're a DJ. Can you come play? I was like, you haven't really heard me play yet. But then they were like, yo, we're just going to take a chance. And
that's so cool.
That worked out.
And how's it been, the reception? I bet you've got a lot of jealousy out there.
100%. And especially from DJs that I know that I was cool with. Then after I started
female
DJing.
DJs or all
both.
DJs? Really?
But both.
DJs are nasty people, bro.
I'm not going to take your gigs. If you're that good, you're that good.
Why are you worried? Yeah.
Yeah, like, it's the same with acting. If, like, a younger actress comes on the scene and they're popping. I am too. Like, who's to say we can't both be good? If you're really good and you're confident 100%. And you know what you're doing, own your space. Mm-hmm. Ah, look at how he's looking at me.
So there's been pushback, eh?
Yes.
It's funny, same as us. The more restaurants are open, the less friends I had. It's just...
I still love you.
Thank you. But you don't come visit, only if we pay you.
I'm always here.
That's a good
point.
He
is in the East.
Listen, I used to be my spot. I'd come here,
pick up a check, and go home.
And go to my gig. I'd come here for dinner, eat, drink, and go to my gig.
Okay.
Gigs.
And then what happened?
You moved to the East, and we kind of morphed. But listen,
we're still on you.
So if someone had just said to you, Khanya, what are you? Boom, actress first, eh? Always.
Always
actress.
Even though I started as a presenter, because that just comes naturally to me. I can just like speak. But acting I really, really love. And I think DJing is my, what's it called?
Love, passion.
No.
Oh
my
gosh,
I mustn't say it like that because then people are going to be like, she said no, like that. No, it's just like my alter ego.
Okay.
Yeah. It's like I get to be wild. When I'm acting, I have to be like, I have to play a certain character.
But you were wild before your DJ days.
I feel like I'm wilder with my DJ.
No, but I'll tell you, but what you both do incredibly well is that I call it theatre DJs. You know what I mean?
Yes. Mm. You put on a show.
You really do, because it's quite simple just to fall back and, you know, but you guys are entertaining to watch.
Yeah.
You are very theatrical and you are very, like, very much crowd interaction.
Yes.
You know what I mean? You're just dodging panties.
And bras.
Making me sound like
and
this.
Bras.
It's true. But that is a big thing.
I feel like it's also because we have fun with it.
Yeah.
I feel like for me, that's my biggest thing. When I play a song, I'm like, oh my gosh, I've been wanting to hear the song. So generally, like, even if I wasn't playing, I'd be like dancing to it. So it's the same thing.
You get
I'm
paid
just
to
having
it.
Fun. Yeah.
So tell me, and Jordan is representing you, eh? Is he your agent?
Oh, he's not my agent. I call him my booking manager, but he's always slacking at this point. I mean, he's my friend, he knows it, but like, oh my gosh, Jordy, if you're watching Friend, you know.
Does he
I mean, why is he not here right now?
If he books you here, does he take a cut?
No, he can't.
He could.
Because he didn't technically book me here. You guys wanted me, yes.
Yeah.
And also, if he wasn't slacking, he would be here.
Okay, so guy, note yourself.
If also, I feel like he doesn't need to take a cut because clearly you guys are paying him really well.
Yeah.
See, Jordy, I'm still on your side.
Okay, so where to from here? Carl, I want to go to you. Please get up.
His phone's off. No, we were trying to phone Jordan.
Oh, we were trying to phone Jordan.
We were literally trying to phone him, but he's not. I think he's watching, going, Carl's phone's in his hand. They're talking about Jordan.
No, but you know what he's going to do?
Try to cuck you out.
Yeah,
okay,
Carly, yes. Quickly. I know you spent time in Ibiza.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then Ibiza sound is always morphing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The South African sound, probably led by coffee.
Yeah.
Is very much following what they're doing over there. Do you see yourself going there and setting up camp overseas, or are you going to play seasons? But you're too good to just be here, bro. What's the plan?
So this was going to be a big year for me, man. Myself and my brother, we have an alias called Cinnamon. You know that.
Very well.
Which is where our production sits. Carl Cassim is the presenter, influencer side of, you know, radio, that vibe. And more underground in terms of music.
Mm.
You know me, I like old school and underground.
Mm.
Cinnamon is mainstream festival music, and we were going to play in Brazil this year.
We're going
to the UK. We had lots of stuff lined up. I think
and
in
very
the
cool to do with your brother as well.
Yeah,
huh?
That's fun.
And very cool to do with
very,
your brother.
Very very cool.
Well.
Like it's we've got such an energy behind us. Not many people get to have that synergy behind the decks. I wanna say in the next 3 years we won't be living in South Africa.
So you had bookings in Brazil, bookings
in
Germany?
Yeah, because a lot of our stuff does on Spotify and Apple Music. We get more streams overseas than South Africa.
So how does it work? So you get a lot of streams there. Events organizers would pick this up and say, hey, I love the sound of these boys. I want them at this festival.
Yeah,
you literally
I had two requests in Brazil. Like, we were starting to chat to some people. We were chatting to promoters. Because what happens is they come to South Africa, they hear our music and vice versa. And they're like, your sound will do so well there.
Mm.
You can hear it's like its own vibe. And we were going to just keep pushing. And I think in the next 3 years, if we're not headlining in Brazil and the States, because the States is really something I want to take over. Because, I mean, that's...
There's a gap there now.
A
funny enough, there is a gap.
Dance music.
They've never really had their own sound. They kind of just borrow from sounds in the States. Mm. So they never had a couple of like banging DJs that have just come and said, I'm going to own what's happening here. It's always international sounding DJs, funny enough. And
so
you go to Vegas, I don't think there's one American DJ who plays in Vegas in the season, is
Calvin
there?
Harris is like the king of Vegas. So, I mean, because of what like the likes of Coffee has done, it's really opened a new, they've paved way for us. And my good friend Carl Watson, he was supposed to play Coachella now. We're going to go with him.
That is huge.
Yeah, we were going to go with him, and I mean, I feel really sorry for the guy. Imagine getting booked to play at Coachella and then COVID happens.
Oh, but he'll play next year.
So
the world will return. Everyone thinks
it'll
never be the same. It will be the same.
Yeah.
Yeah, I actually feel sorry for Miss Universe, was he? I mean, it's not like she can return next year.
Yeah.
Like the whole range.
That's
was COVID.
Suck.
Yeah.
I didn't even plan my birthday.
Yeah.
Suddenly you don't feel so bad.
Right? I mean, her whole reign. I was thinking about it the other day. I'm like, she can't return and be like, she's Miss Universe
one
for
year.
Another year. No.
Sorry, guys, one more year. Like, no.
Andor. I'm still here.
So, yeah, if you're feeling sorry for yourself, think of her.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, the next 3 years, lots of big international work.
Nice.
But still ground ourselves in SA because,
yeah,
I mean, this is where it all comes from.
100%.
So, yeah.
Like Coffee's done.
Yeah, 100%.
Still grounded here.
Yeah.
I love that. And you, overseas?
Woo, I'd love to. So I want to tell you about a project I'm actually doing now, apart from my soapy work. I'm starring in a series that's currently in production. It's called Blood Psalms. It's almost like the local version of Game of Thrones. Tando's also in it. It looks insane. I've shot a few scenes. I feel like that's going to be
that's
a game
so cool.
changer. Yeah.
Power.
Blood Psalms.
Yes.
You've heard about it, hey? Yes. 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 Jeez. Like so many
all of our friends are
huge actresses and actors, yeah. It's gonna be epic.
Are you one of the leads?
No. So there's too many of us.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean it's Game of Thrones type.
But they need guest appearances.
Yeah.
Got you.
We would be great villains.
We'd be like a team.
Yeah, we would be like a The Musketeers, but in a really bad way.
I never watched Game of Thrones, so I don't know.
Neither have I.
Me neither.
Well,
it's different. It'd be like, yeah, the Three Musketeers from Game of Thrones, yeah.
Yeah, so that's something I'm working on now, which is really exciting, because I've never done anything like that. I mean, I think South Africa's never seen anything like it. But apart from that, I would want to star in an international movie.
Full-length feature.
Yeah, that would be amazing. Like.
And Netflix is changing the landscape, eh? Yes. Have you seen these Netflix movies coming out? Don't even bother going to big screen. And they're just
pumping it out.
How do they put out as much stuff as they do?
That new Chris Hemsworth movie that was shot in India. Did you see that? It's like one of the highest grossing movies.
Yeah,
and it came straight to Netflix.
It was fantastic.
Did you watch that movie?
Yeah, it was fantastic.
Yes, it's incredible.
Mm. And also the local stuff that's shot here for Netflix, like Blood and
Blood
Water.
And Water.
Yeah. That's really cool.
We need our own Netflix movie.
It's called RocketsTV.
RocketsTV full of technical glitches.
No, man.
No, we're only kidding. Okay, listen, we're running out of time. You know we love you, Julesy.
I know. Thanks,
Jules. Our death captain over there. Okay, so let's start. One thing we do, we always end on two things. One, are you going to play out for us?
Okay, cool.
And we're doing a general knowledge quiz and we have a forfeit. So we've done some pretty gross things in this
RocketsTV.
Yeah, I'm wondering what questions you're going to ask me. I don't trust you.
No, you
so,
you
also, what's
going to
happen?
Brent asked.
What's going to happen?
Okay. So, Brent, it's, no, you guys don't have to forfeit. You just help me.
Okay.
Help you.
Okay.
Okay. So if I get less than two, so one or zero, I lose. Best of three, basically.
Mm. Yeah.
Whoever wins, if I win, Brent has to have his own forfeit. If I lose, I have to have a forfeit.
Yeah. So what we've done is, just because you know today's not such a bad challenge.
Okay.
Like if Sean loses, I'll do it with him.
Okay.
If it's bad.
What are you guys doing?
Really bad. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. What are you guys doing
today?
This is curry paste.
It can't be that bad. It can't be.
Chicken's face. I'm not saying.
He's like, did you say curry paste?
You had me at hello.
Gosh, I missed you. Okay,
just for Carl.
Okay,
for
let's go with the questions then.
I could have made it cinnamon.
Could have made it cinnamon.
Oh, that we did that.
Did you?
The cinnamon challenge, have you seen?
I saw the chili one you guys did.
The Paki chip challenge in the 24 hour.
Oh.
That was heavy, yeah.
That was tough.
Okay,
questions.
Here we go.
At what age does a lamb become a mutton?
12.
How old is your...
Jesus, dude. Yeah. Can I give you the like
sorry,
two answers?
Just,
like, okay, is it 6 months?
No.
Is it a year? Is it 2 years?
2 years.
Yes, I've always wondered about
it
this.
Would
be 2 years would be too long.
Yeah, maybe a year. Between a year and two.
I say 6 months.
Ah! No way. I say a year.
6 months.
I should have stuck with 2 years.
Bad question.
A year. It's definitely a year.
6 months.
Okay, 6 months. You're wrong. It's 1 year.
I knew it!
1 year.
I knew it!
Okay.
Jules, you're not allowed to help.
Yeah,
it's a good question, though.
It's not
yeah, he wasn't going to listen anyway. He won.
Sorry, man.
That's a good point.
No,
so I lose. I got it wrong.
He's got 1 year.
No, but there's another. Aren't there three questions?
Yes, if Sean gets the next one.
I gotta get the next two right.
I'm just saying. It's not fair. This is not fair. Okay. How many?
Liverpool playing tonight, by the way. I'm playing Arsenal.
Yeah, did you see Man United's game? Yes, we do. 90 minutes.
96 minutes.
How many?
Two.
No.
Are you
want
to ask? You
want
the question?
Yes.
Two. How many black and white squares? Hey, don't you? Does he look at your
I know, I
bro,
saw.
I'm blind as a bat. I can't even see what phone that is.
Okay, how many black and white squares are there on a chessboard?
Oh, that's too hard.
Is it 64, 66, or 68? 64.
Well, how many pieces are there?
I'd say 64.
So there's, no, it's how many pieces are there, and you just times it by two. So
no,
there's
64 is
there's,
even enough.
I don't know.
There's two prawns. What is it, a prawn? No, it's prawn. A prawn.
So 8 porn. Times 8 is 64, and I would say there'd be 8 across.
Yeah, 64, don't worry, 64. He's right, and Jules is also right. So
thank you. 64. My math,
I would have done 8.
No, you said 64. I heard you said 64.
Okay, last question.
That's fine.
Okay. Last question.
All right, bonus question. What is a contagious disease? Varicella.
What?
But you can't even. You can't even.
Varicella, more commonly known as. Yes.
Okay. Let's hear. Varicella.
Measles, mumps, or chicken pox.
But you say it properly.
Okay, varicella.
How do you spell it?
V-A-R-C-I. V-A-R-I-C-E-L-L-A.
I say chicken pox. Yeah.
Say it again?
I would say
varicella
measles.
Is measles, chicken pox, or mumps?
Or mumps.
I'd say measles. You say chicken pox. But it's probably,
give me another question.
Yeah, that's
no, that's too much pressure.
Give me another question.
Yeah, give us another question, but tell us the answer.
No, that's a great question.
But tell us the answer. No, but we're skipping that one. Just tell us the answer.
I'm skipping it.
Was it chicken pox or measles?
Measles.
Chicken pox.
I was right. I was right.
No, 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 do your last question, please.
I'll give you another one. That's an easy one. Brazil is the largest exporter of which product? Is it
Cohiba?
Cocaine? Or coffee?
I would have thought...
I'd say it again. What?
Brazil nuts? Okay. Brazil is the largest exporter of which product? Is it Brazil nuts? Coffee? Or cocaine?
Coffee.
But why would you have a Brazil nut?
I was thinking of...
Brazilian nuts.
who else exports Brazil nuts?
I don't know. That's what the answer is.
Anyway.
So I definitely won.
You
did win, yeah.
But you weren't really part of
Let's
it,
forfeit,
so it
come.
Doesn't really matter.
Bop.
Okay, so you guys have those, eh?
No, you can have one.
Why?
Because.
Yeah, and it's Carey Price, right?
I don't have one.
Wow.
It's affected.
What did you guys say?
I'm running in the morning.
Because I need to have one.
Share this.
Okay. Just eat the whole thing, dude.
This is not a taste test.
No, but why? I don't want to drink my mouth right now.
You have to.
No, I don't. No, I don't. That's wrong.
How you going to follow, bro?
The faces are going red. It's not the TV.
Bro, that is horrific. Did you put anything else in?
Yeah.
What?
Why?
It's on top of gas.
Oh. I hate you. I hate that stuff. And what the hell?
Sorry, guys.
Did you do this in case I was meeting a chick later?
No,
I was going to want this.
No, but you said you're running tomorrow. Which one is it? And you said, and when I said I had load shedding, you were like, oh, well, I live here, so
no.
What's your story?
Maybe he's trying to make me not talk to you.
No, you definitely can talk. I think it'd be a great mix-up.
Should I go play a salon?
No, wait. We're gonna. Carl, sit, man.
Sit.
Great.
Yum.
Okay. Well, this is our very haphazard Rockets TV episode for the night. How disgusting was that?
Why was it haphazard?
Because
I feel
cool.
Like all your shows are always like this.
It wasn't formatted very well, but it was better. I love it like this.
Really?
And I like the fact you guys are in studio as opposed to streaming.
I love
or being
that.
There. It's cool. This is what it's all about.
And remember the last time I was streaming, my neighbor was knocking and she was saying I was loud.
Oh, you weren't loud.
Oh, honestly.
Well, we were your favorite
my
guest.
My neighbor.
You have been our two favorite guests by far. So remember to subscribe.
You say that to everyone.
No, I don't. We're trying to get people to migrate from Facebook plays to YouTube because Facebook, we can't play music.
Yeah.
They always kick us out. So just if
and
you're watching this, please subscribe.
No
subscribe
one
to
is
our
on
YouTube
Facebook.
Channel. Click on notifications and then let's migrate.
And check out our new app.
And yeah, check out the new app. That's coming soon as well.
Oh,
yeah, we'll put on our Instagram for you guys.
Okay, we'll put on Instagram.
Nice.
But yeah, thanks, Julesy. But Carl, we
love
you
too. Ah,
bro, we love you, man.
I love you too.
I love you.
We get to
you
listen to you on Friday night. 4 hours Friday night.
He knows nothing about the show, but
I'm a big fan.
He's gonna jump on, yeah.
You?
No, I'm gonna be listening.
We'll put you on.
You loyal, I know.
I've been working.
Like
too much.
Sean hears it from going to the shops.
No, I get you up. That's why he walks into the shop like this. I'm ready.
I do love it. You know what I don't like though?
What?
It's all those guys who keep on phoning in or sending their voice notes,
yes.
And it ruins the song. Can't you stop that?
You know what?
Or maybe play it towards the end.
Mm-hmm. Because you play the best music, right? You play the best music, and then you have hey, Carl Cassim, on fire tonight. I'm drinking with my mates.
I thought that was you sending it.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, sorry, I'm trying to get rid of this taste in my mouth.
Bro, it's
do you want to have some like it?
What was Carl?
Does he have a cooking show?
Carl
does
have
a cooking
show.
Curry paste.
No, there was something else in it.
You put
I didn't taste it, but there's no way.
You put tartaric acid in there, man.
Tartaric acid.
Both bad.
And I must go have a chicken salad for dinner.
No comments. No comments.
I feel weird.
Yeah.
Anyway, if you are there, let's sign off. Okay. To everybody watching, please be safe, stay warm, look after your families, social distance, sanitize.
Wear a mask.
Okay.
And subscribe to Rockets TV.
And look out for the new app.
My name is Sean. This is Brent. Thanks for hanging out with me.
This world famous car Cassim, world famous country. We love.
It's been amazing. We love you guys.
Love you guys. Be safe.
Go play something.
Oh yeah.
Amazing.
I forgot. I'm still on the job.
On the job. Good way, chat.
Nice boys. Thank you.
'Cause
trips that you plan for the next whole week. Been too long for a nigga so cheap. And your flex OD, your sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it.
Hey.
You got it, girl, you got it.
Yeah. Pretty little thing, you got a bag and now you wildin'. You just took it off the line, no mileage. Waiting, hitting you the DM, looking violent. Talking while you come around and now they silent. Blue the Cooper 17, no guidance. You be staying low, but you know what the price is. Ain't never got you, know it, being modest. Popping, shipping only cause you know you popping, yeah. You got it, girl, you got it. Hey. You got it, girl, you got it. I heard you got a new girl.
What you know about going out? Big check, big check. Don't care, die for my wrist. Life, we gon' live it up. Neck, we gon' glitter it up. Dice game, get them, girl. Gon' bet it up. Grind and invest it. Invest, play the main role, not the exit. Made movies like Netflix, never domestic. Watching the necklace, young and I'm restless. You know who the best is. Back three quarter Gucci Mane with the first shoe. Got a girl and the girl got a girl too. Hit me with the fab, like put it in the bag. Pull up with my new tank, like I know she mad.
Angelina, you the cool in my temperature. If you call, I go and deliver. I no go fall in your hand never. So now me, you could love forever. I'm a cocky, no feeble letter. I'm a angelina, Angelina. I'm a angelina, Angelina. Oh, me all down. Anytime when I see you for the club or the television, your body. Sure you know no say, the thing when you carry, if you kill somebody. You know I feel a vibe, you feel a vibe, so baby, whine about me, yeah. And I know you shy, but it's cool when we're making love. On the low, 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 on the low. Angelina, Angelina, you the cool in my temperature. Your hand in never. So now me you could love forever. I'm a cocky no feeble letter. I'm a angel, Angelina. I'm a angel, Angelina. Oh no. So when I want to come out, make a signal. But you want to request in your me like an interview. I'm trying to put a ring on your finger too. And be a better guy, guy. Be a better guy, guy.
VIP, no guest list. TT Raw, you don't know, who you with.
Got my other chick, hugging on my other chick. Hugging all night, nigga, we ain't sell a bit. Fat damn, too dope, I ain't selling it. But I'm fresher than a peppermint. Go let him in, his last game killing it. Young money, yeah, we getting rich. Get your grandma on my girl, you know what it is. Rack City chick, rack city chick. Rack City chick, rack city chick. Rack City chick, rack city chick. TNT. 20s and a 50s chick. Rack City chick, rack city chick. Rack City chick, rack city chick. Rack City chick, rack city chick. 10 20s and a 50s chick. I'm a motherfucker. Look at the paint on the car. Too much rim, make the ride too hard. Now that shit pop out, walk the boulevard.
Another man food is another man poison.
Go.
You know fine, but in my mind like I'm
go.
Oh yeah, sure you won't come calculate my money.
Go.
Oh yeah, you want to dance or you want to shake? Oh,
oh yeah,
who got the blessing, bless oh.
Oh yeah,
chop the rice and banana.
Oh yeah,
I go do my best oh. Yeah, chop the way do one banga.
Oh yeah,
but you don't start oh. Shall you got love for the matata? Slim daddy,
I love my life, I love my life, I love my life.
So we are coming in with a force, yeah. Blessings we are reaping, we coursing on foot. Oh, in a rise and boast. Yeah, we give thanks like we need it the most. We have to give thanks like we really supposed to be thankful. Blessings all for my life, and So I mean to give him the go, breathe, I'm in the lies. And Jano tell me passion ignited. Got the music, me excited. I'm coming like a potion. Mm-hmm. Blessings all for my life and my thank God for the journey, the earnings, and just for the plots. Yeah. Gratitude is a must. Yeah. Blessings all by my right hand. What's a toast for the friends with the car? We be load one time, bitch, sit down in a class and we pour ten. Only set the road and we go on with the road. Toast.
Bossy, bossy. Godfather, man a OG. Toast. Man a half humble, man a bossy. Fling a rag a rhythm and a soul. Bossy, house on the coast, G. My money so long it doesn't know me. It's looking at my kids like I'm bossy.
But the bang, 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 hey.
Hey yo, Idris, tell them how they gonna take the. One step, you step out, do that, turn up in a diss. Body comfortable, I'm a physically fit. I'm a brown and sweet, just like the chocolate.
Yo, Wiley,
them ones don't like me. Other than a pretty, pretty with the upper body. Shut down in the city with me bad girl. Every man want a piece of me. The back of them a pop and them a bun. Man want wine behind me, me off a move and dusty. I'm looking for a brother who got hella pounds. 079, baby, I'm a hammer, did you saw?
Bossy, bossy. Godfather, man a OG. Man a half humble, man a bossy. Fling a rag a rhythm like it's all free. Bossy, house on the coast, G. My money so long it doesn't know me. It's looking at my kids like I'm bossy.
Ayo, Sean.
Ayo. So when me spitty funny with it, maybe gala get with it. Spitty funny with it, maybe gala get. When me trippy funny with it, maybe gala get with it. Wind up your body and spin it. Girl, when you bubble, that's a trouble. Why you give me this something, now turn it around and bring it. You're pressing it back on and on, never push that button. My girl, don't bother, go and tame it. Once you broke out and fling it. Once your body shaking up to the limit. Once you wild out to wild it to S to the base. Step London and mid on edges. Is it?
Bossy.
I came to rap, you know, do my thing. Sabi put me on the gram, you know, remix thing. Pull tight Wiley with the Pacino flow. Godfather part 2, call me De Niro. I came to win, battle me, that's a sin. Disrespect, man, get a slap on the chin. Man a king in a top, oh Larry. Man a big DJ, Hawks, Megan and Harry. Boss, yeah, man a boss, yeah. I make a girl melt like a toast, yeah. I'll be this way someday. And I write for myself, no ghosting.
Needs a boy, got money in a bank on. Ready for roll and blaze up this tank on. Got the girls from Japan to Hong Kong. The girl them champion, in it.
Bossy, bossy. Godfather, man a OG. Man a half humble, man a bossy. Fling a rag a rhythm with a soul free.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. This one I better do with the jabada. Me, I no get time, I did jabada. Dada cover my face, calling me labada. Biggie man, we know they wear abada. Tell me, my nigga, what's it gonna be? G-Wagon, all the Bentley, the Kelton, ride the boat, I no feet, die for nothing, my nigga, what's it gonna be? G-Wagon, all the Bentley, the Kelton, ride the boat, I no feet, die for nothing. Make you no say anything when you do, they must commend it.
I can't come and keep myself.
So anything when you do, I dey try to do on my way.
Tell Uncle Luke, I'm out in Miami too. Clubbing hard, fucking women, ain't much to do. Wrist playing, got a condo up on Biscayne. Still getting brain from a thing, ain't changed. How you feel, how you feel, how you feel? 25 sitting on 25 mil, I'm in the building and I'm feeling myself. Rest in peace, Mac Dre. I'ma do it for the bay, okay? Getting paid, we'll holler whenever that stop. My team good, we don't really need a mascot. Tell Tune Light One, pass it like a relay. YMCMB, you need more YMCA. Me, Franny, and Molly Mall at the cribbo. Shot goes out to Nico, J and Chubb, shot to Gibbo. We got Santa Margarita by the leader. She know even if I'm fucking with her, I don't really need her. Oh, that's how you feel, man, it's really how you feel. Cause the pimpin' nice cold, all this just
wanna chill, I mean, maybe she won't. Then again, maybe she will. I can almost guarantee she know the deal. Real nigga, now she want a photo. You already know though, you only live once, that's the motto, nigga YOLO. And we bout it every day, every day, every day. They be sitting on the bench, but we don't really play. Every day, every day, what anybody say. Can't see him cause the money in the way. Real, what's up?
One time for one time, I'm calling it out like the umpire. 7 grams in the blunt, almost drowned in the poop. So I swam to a boat, bitch. Eastside, we in this dude. Wishing up wood like a tree in this dude. And if a leaf fall, put some shit in that boot. That's my M.O. at a beat. Way back way, you know that I don't play. Streets not safe, but I never run away, even when I'm away. OT, OT, there's never much love when we go OT. I pray to make it back in one piece. I pray, I pray. That's why I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking. I was taking